As discussed in the previous chapter, pushed by the European CO2 regulation, the EV market is meant to be primarily driven by the offer. However, other factors, fast-forwarded by the current COVID-19 pandemic, are gaining weight, accelerating the EV adoption and the role that electric vehicles will play in the months to come. Most of the European countries and cities across Europe, conscious that the quality of their air is far from the agreed air quality standards, have been working on different measures to decrease the pollution, such as zero emission zones, low emission zones, and/or direct restriction to diesel and petrol engines. Bristol announced that they would be the very first city in the UK to completely ban diesels from 2021. Rome also announced the banning of diesels, but from 2024. Norway, leading the path, announced the complete stop of ICE car sales from 2025, and so did the UK, but for 2035. These measures and announcements were made before the COVID-19 crisis. Nowadays, in September 2020, all the experts agree that the timelines for these measures will be brought forward in time, and that they will become much stricter, pushed by the increased awareness of the citizens. Awareness acquired during the worst period of the pandemic, when the levels of contamination in the major cities across Europe decreased by up to 54%. In order to renovate the car park and improve the road emissions while supporting the automotive sector, most of the governments in Europe have launched and reviewed several incentive programs in the last few months, pushing for the adoption of clean powered cars. In France, for example, these incentives can go up to 12,000 euros for the purchase of an EV. In Italy, up to 10,000 euros. Germany, up to 9,000 euros. Or the Netherlands, where you get a governmental bonus of 4,000 euros on a new EV and 2,000 euros on used EVs. Added to this direct payment, EV buyers will also benefit from other incentives, such as the reduction on taxes, support for the EV points installation, free highways and public parking, or free charging costs, just to mention a few. All of what will make the adoption of electric vehicles much more attractive. We see in the market an increasing appetite amongst consumers to make the switch to EVs. The main reason for it are the following. First of all, they're demonstrated reliability. Electric vehicles are little by little no longer seen as something unheard of or unknown. The end user is starting to see their development and results, proving wrong a lot of the myths or expectations, such as the range anxiety or the resistance of the batteries. The benefits of owning and driving an EV are also becoming more transparent for the end user. EV owners highlight, amongst others, the comfort and safety that electric vehicles offer, the reduced total cost of ownership, mainly driven by the very little maintenance cost and low charging cost, and of course, the lower environmental footprint. The effects of all the factors described during this episode are already visible in the EV penetration across Europe, which has already doubled versus last year, representing a great opportunity for both new and used car professionals. You can't miss out on the electrifying content that we are preparing for you. Stay tuned and subscribe to our channel, Get Electric with BCAJ.